We are pressing record because we are going to record a video about perfectionism, which is why I've been avoiding making this video because I've been wanting it to be perfect. Full circle. Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Alex B, and this is Alex Bewell. And in today's video, I wanted to tell you that you are not perfect and you will never be perfect. Thank you so much for watching. No, just kidding. We like to have fun here on this channel. And this video is about perfectionism and how perfectionism can be holding you back from reaching so many of the goals that you want to reach. You may be asking yourself, am I a perfectionist? Well, let's find out together. If you have really high expectations for yourself and beat yourself up if you don't meet those expectations, you may be a perfectionist. If you avoid trying new things because you're afraid that you're not gonna do it perfectly, you may be a perfectionist. If you are constantly comparing your results to those of others, you may be a perfectionist. Perfectionism is something that I didn't even really realize I was dealing with that. And now that I realize this, now that I know better, I want to start doing better. So here are some ways to get through perfectionism to reach your goals. Number one is don't be afraid to be a beginner. You can't be worse than a beginner. And when you begin, it's gonna suck. So just get over the fact that's gonna suck. Start now so you can get the sucky part out of the way. Like, I prolonged creating this YouTube channel because I was so just afraid of the unknown and like how everything would turn out. And I was worried that how they were gonna look and that they were gonna look shitty. And you know what? They look shitty because those are my first videos, and that's okay. In a year from now, who knows what my videos are gonna be able to look like. If you wanna make movies, oftentimes you're probably comparing yourself to like Steven Spielberg or the Jurassic Park movies. Instead of as a student filmmaker, you should be comparing yourself to Steven Spielberg's first films. That's what I did when I was starting YouTube, is there's all these people that I really looked up to and whose videos are so awesome. And what I did is I went back to their first videos. Ooh, yikes. So unless you're some sort of prodigy, you're gonna suck the first time, and that's okay. So just start now, get the shitty part out of the way. Which leads me on to my next point, which is do your best. One of the books that I recommend the most is called The Four Agreements by Don Miguel Ruiz. And the fourth agreement is to always do your best. Because under any circumstance that you are doing your best, it helps you avoid that inner mean voice telling you that it's not good enough, saying you suck. It's a way to quiet that inner self-critic and inner judge. And remembering that your best is gonna change from day to day, even from moment to moment. Let's take the gym for example. My best is always gonna change. It's gonna depend on what time I go, if I ate before, my mood. I think the most important thing is to just show up and do your best. Perfection often stops us from taking action. It scares us. Scared of messing up, making a fool of ourselves, making an ass out of ourselves. Scared of what people might think. When you do your best, you're more likely to reach those goals. And by doing your best, it keeps your expectations for yourself lower. When the bar is lower, it's way easier to jump over it. And if you fall short, don't punish yourself. And sometimes when your perfectionism gets so bad, it can manifest itself into OCD-like behaviors, or in my case, eating disorder-like behaviors. Or an eating disorder, I should just say that. And the third way to try to beat perfectionism is reminding yourself, done is better than perfect. Because nothing is perfect. Do you think Steven Spielberg thinks Jurassic Park is perfect? I bet if he turns on that movie, he's still like, God fucking damn it. That angle on that Tyrannosaurus top. I don't know my dinosaurs. You know what I'm saying. Especially in a sort of creative work. Because I always feel like creative work never has an ending. Oftentimes I'll make videos, record them, upload them, but I'll keep them on private because there's still a part of me that's like, oh, maybe there's something I can tweak there. Maybe there's something I could have said better, or did I leave anything out? Even right now, I'm like, oh, should I just like start over this video? Because I want to make sure that everything I'm saying makes sense. But I need to trust myself that this is good. This is the best that I can do right now. And we're gonna upload this. Well, now I've been asking myself, what would I do if I knew I didn't have to do it perfectly? Last year, I would have said started a YouTube channel. I'm doing it now. I'm still not doing it perfectly, but I'm learning. Every video I make, I learn something new and I add it to the next one, and I hope each video is going to be better than the one the week before, even easier than the week before. So what would you try to do if you knew you didn't have to do it perfectly? Would you write that book? Would you try stand-up? Would you try to ask someone out? For me, I would love to back into a parking space. That seems so scary to me because I feel like if I even attempted to do it, I would hit any cars around me and explode. But I have to know that the first time I attempt this, it's not gonna go perfectly.
Reverse.
People are gonna be watching.
A little off.
Close enough.
Close enough. Watch it, and I'll be backing it up.
All right. No. This way.
He's in. So do it.
All right.
Rattling the more
nights. Better than that guy.
Yeah, for sure. That's horrible.
And once something is done and completed, you can check it off your list, and that helps build confidence to keep moving through. I was almost afraid to look like a beginner, which is not self-acceptance. I think I should have accepted that I was a beginner and start where I am instead of where I am looking to where I want to be. So just remember, you're not going to be perfect. That's literally the mantra I tell myself is, psh, you're not gonna do it perfectly, so let's just fucking do it anyway. What do you got to lose? And especially if it's the first time I do something, I always tell myself, this is the worst you are ever gonna be at this. So even though we are not perfect, we can always remember to do our best, always accept where we are, and we can stop letting perfectionism stopping us from trying out new things. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and make sure you subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.